Hi, my name is Michael Hintz from the Pankow Center, and this is the Graphic Arts and Design Technology program. We were asked by Karen Olson from the Great Start Collaborative Coordinator of Macomb Intermediate School District to design what we call installation pieces of art. They're very large pieces of art, 5 feet by 6 feet, presentation panels, walls. This is the third year in a row that we've done these. The month of March is called the month of the young child, and so she asks us to come up with some presentations to put on the walls for their big meetings and classrooms and their celebration at the end of the week. This year's theme was youth literacy, or reading and writing. So each of the groups, we designed the program to fit groups. So each panel had a group of students, anywhere from 2 to 3 students, all the way up as far as 5 to 6 students. They would collaborate on a design idea, and then each of them would participate in where their strengths were, whether it be drawing, design, painting, illustrations, even if it's cutting pieces out. They're not all considered to be flat because we have space we can use, although they're all mounted onto a surface. The students work with different techniques. It could be paper tolling, which is a matter of cutting paper out in multiple layers to create a dimensional look, or students actually have used paper mache and wire framing to cut out little characters, to even stuffed animals, real world products like books and magazines. So you can see from the presentation that there's several different ideas that the students were able to come up with based on this one singular theme. Once we received the project from the client, I introduced the project to the students, and then I show them samples. Now, in the beginning, we didn't have any samples, but now that we've done this several years, I have at least some ideas to show them. Or I show them professional samples of what an installation or large format projects would look like. Now, going through the natural way of doing any sort of artwork projects, you start off with your idea process, or in our case, thumbnails. So I require each student in the group to come up with their own design idea, as if they were building it themselves. Because then they have some buy-in to the piece. Now, because they are in a group, it may not necessarily be their piece that gets chosen. But it doesn't mean that they can't combine pieces together to develop the best piece, which is in fact what the ones that are the nicest is what they've done.
The idea that my group came up with, we wanted to have the idea that when you're reading a book, it really comes to life. And so what we're going to have is, it's a window, and outside the window, you have the Wizard of Oz scene, and you have the four main characters, and we have this doll that's going to be reading the book, and it's the Wizard of Oz book. So the idea is, as he's reading it, it's coming to life outside of his window.
And this isn't done yet, right?
No.
So what else do you have to add to it?
We have a window frame, which has certain parts of the characters, and then the tornado, and then just putting the book in the scene.
This is a project of a window where it pops out of a foster home. We want the kids to, any and every child to be welcomed in the foster home with the windows and the ABCs, numbers, letters, and a flower pot and a roof that sticks out that's showing the kids you are welcome in a foster home.
Now, how long did something like this take you to do?
Actually, quite a while. We worked hard on it, but it shouldn't take us as long as we thought it should have been.
What you're looking at is Once Upon a Time. That is actually the basis for our whole project. It was what got us started. A groupmate of mine said, whenever we think children's literature, what's the first thing we think? Once Upon a Time. So going off of that, we wanted a sort of fantasy landscape, which gave us these mountains and hills and the night sky. Here we have the literacy tie-in, a mother reading to her child, and they are sitting in a tree in their backyard. The idea was to build the tree in layers, and by the end of this, it was so big we couldn't just we couldn't just tack it onto the board, so we made a support beam for it.
So, Mom, are you excited that his work's going to be featured over here?
Yes, I am. He's had other works featured in other locations. Very proud of his artistic ability.
Giving tree. So we have, we had to take him off, but we have this guy sitting right here, like reading, and then we have this girl receiving a book, and then there's the tree, which has like knowledge and stuff on it, and that's gonna go on the top of the trunk, and then she's gonna be like getting this book. So, well, I came up with the idea, and the group just went with it, and we kind of enhanced the way the drawings would look, and then made it, because on the cover, there's just one person, and then we had him reading.
It's really a good project to do as teams, as groups, although teams and groups don't always get along, but you have to learn that that's the way the business works. There is not only one project for one person for every single job. And this is a great opportunity for us, not only to market our program, but as each individual student gets their name put on the wall as part of that group and what school they go to, it represents their school and themselves as the quality of the work that they can produce. And Ms. Olson and all of the ISD are extremely appreciative of all that we do.